Good morning, this is Mission Control Houston. Welcome, and thank you for joining us for today's edition of ISS Update this Thursday, July 19. The six crew members aboard the station include Russian cosmonaut and commander of the complex Gennady Padaka, and flight engineers cosmonaut Sergei Revin, NASA astronaut Joe Acaba, and now cosmonaut Yuri Malenchenko, NASA astronaut Sunny Williams, and Japanese astronaut Aki Hoshide. After a morning inspection and breakfast, the Expedition 32 crew participated in the first of two daily planning conferences that was held with ground controllers at mission control centers around the world to review today's activities. Commander Padaka, with flight engineer Sergei Revin, spent some time this morning working with the Russian topology experiment that studies a crew member's psychophysical state during long-duration spaceflight. Padaka then turned his attention for most of today with Malenchenko's assistants preparing the docked Progress 47. This is the Russian cargo ship for its undocking this weekend. Progress 47 is set to undock from the Piers docking compartment on Sunday at 3:27 p.m. Central Time. The cargo ship will back away from the station and redock on Monday night. The vehicle's undock and redock exercise is to test a new Russian docking system. We'll bring you live coverage of the initial undocking Sunday at 3 p.m. Central Time here on NASA TV. Meanwhile, flight engineer Joe Acaba stowed the formaldehyde monitoring kits and then worked with Aki Hoshide to remove and replace a pre-treat tank and hose of the waste and hygiene compartment. Acaba and Hoshide then began focus on another day of robotics on board training of a vehicle rendezvous approach in advance of the arrival of the third Japanese cargo ship. This is the H-2 transfer vehicle, or Kunitori 3. The cargo ship is scheduled to launch from the Tanegashima Space Center in Japan on Friday night at 9:06 p.m. Central Time. Live coverage of the cargo ship will begin here on NASA TV at 8:15 p.m. Central Time, 9:15 p.m. Eastern Time. Meanwhile, flight engineers Joe Acaba, Sunny Williams, and Aki Hoshide participated in an HTV3 timeline conference to review the upcoming cargo ship's arrival. They then participated in onboard training of the vehicle's rendezvous and approach. Hoshide participated in an educational event for the Tanegashima Educational Board and Manami Nihon Broadcasting Company and answered questions from 11 students in Japan. Flight engineer Sunny Williams began her morning getting her hands in science. She activated the microgravity science glove box to be used in her first operation with research known as BAS, or burning and suppression of solids, that studies the characteristics of a wide variety of fuel samples in microgravity. These research results may aid in the design of fire detection and suppression systems in microgravity and on Earth. Williams also spent some time on her first journal entry as part of the journal study and participated in a private medical conference. The Expedition 32 crew members are currently reviewing the depressed fire and ammonia release emergency crew roles and responsibility. They will follow up their busy second day as a full six-member crew with some evening prep work before their evening meal and pre-sleep period. They'll also participate in their final daily planning conference before bedtime. The crew is then scheduled to go to bed at 4:30 p.m. Central Time. This is Mission Control Houston.